Hey friends, let me show you a simple way for a Lambda function to create and pull data from AWS DocumentDb. Let's take a look at the code. I'm using Mongoose. It's a very powerful framework to interact with the document database, and it also works with MongoDB. So we start by defining an URI, so the connection string to the database, and then we create a schema and a model from a person. We connect, we create two new persons, and then we retrieve them, and then we return the results, and that's it. I can try this out locally with a MongoDB like this. So it connects and fetches two persons. Let's zip the code so we can upload it to a Lambda function. Let's create a new Lambda function from scratch, my Lambda, Node.js 20, and create. It's ready. Let's now upload the zip file. The code is here. Let's next create security groups. So we go into EC2 and security groups, and let's create one for the Lambda, so Lambda SG, and we allow no inbound traffic and all outbound traffic. And next we create another security group and we call it DocSG, and we allow inbound traffic from the default port from our other security group, the Lambda security group, and create. Let's now connect our Lambda to the same VPC our DocumentDB will be running in. We go into configuration and permissions, open our role in a new tab. We need to attach a policy here. So we write here VPC and find the execution role here and add permission. Then we can go back into VPC and edit this one here. Find our VPC, add all subnets, and add here the security group that we created, so the Lambda SG. Save. So this might take a while. Let's create the document DB. So we find here document and we open it in a new tab and we create a new cluster, instance based, and we find the cheapest one. It might cost some money still, so we need to remember to turn it off. And one instance, document standard, don't connect to EC2 compute. And then we just create some username and password and create. Let's go into our cluster and there we can find some instructions. So we need this permission file. So let's copy that here and let's fetch it into our code and create a new zip file for it. And let's go into our Lambda again and upload this file here for Lambda. And then we can see it here. Then we need the URI or connection string. So we copy that here and go into our Lambda, configuration, environment variables, edit, add URI. Then we add this here. And then we insert our password and save. Let's now change the security group. So we go here into modify and we find here the document security group and remove the default one. And we save this. All right, let's now try it out. You press the test button here. It's working, so it returned 200 and some data. Remember to delete everything once you're done. So you can go into the cluster here, modify, and remove this, enable deletion protection, continue, modify cluster, and then we can select the cluster and delete it. No, and delete entire cluster, acknowledge, delete. And then for the Lambda, that's simpler, we just delete it like this. That's it for this video. I hope you liked it. It can be tricky to get everything working, because if you get one thing wrong, then it's very hard to see why it's not working. So please reach out to me if you need any help. Thank you.